Hi there, I'm Eliza and I'm a biblical counselor, and today I want to share with you a little activity that you can do to work with children who have a difficult time regulating their emotions. And this means you have a child who maybe responds too intensely with their emotions. Maybe they get really angry or they get really upset and they cry out or they scream really loud when they maybe just bumped themselves but it sounds like they've been really hurt. Or perhaps they cry a lot and things move them to tears really quickly. Now obviously you want to be careful that you're not missing something else going on in the child's life, but if this is sort of the characteristic of the child, this activity could help you. So you just need a sheet of paper and you're going to draw a vertical line with two points on it. So I did it here. And you're going to start with this bottom point. And the bottom point is where you're going to ask the child to talk about something that is upsetting to them, but doesn't like ruin the day. They didn't like it, but it was okay. And you maybe give them a scenario that has happened or something that could happen. Maybe they came down for breakfast, dad poured them Cheerios, they were hoping for Rice Krispies. They were upset, but they were able to get over it okay. And you're going to put whatever those situations are that you've seen the child kind of work through okay at the bottom here. And you want to mark it on the line and put a picture to describe it if the child's younger, or you could write it out. So I just marked it with an X so you know what where it fell. Then you're going to go to the top. And on the top is where you're going to talk with the child about things that are very upsetting to them, things that where they would actually need help, where they would need to scream out. Maybe when they really did, if something really did happen where they hurt themselves, perhaps the child has had a severe injury before and they cried hard, or maybe it's just a really upsetting situation. Maybe they lost a family pet or something, or a good friend moved away and they were sad for several days, and maybe even mom and dad cried in that situation. And you're going to put that towards the top and mark that for them so they can see where that would fall. Then what you want to do is you want to use this as a way, and again, you would create it a little bit more detailed, putting pictures or writing it out so that they could see this. But this is going to be their point of reference. So the next time they have a scenario, maybe a situation happened in their class where a child took their pencil and they responded pretty intensely. Maybe they cried for a while and they got pretty upset in the classroom. You want to bring them back to this chart and say, okay, sweetie, if this is where we would be if maybe somebody needed a lot of help, or we were really sad because we lost a family pet and mom and dad are even upset and crying, where do you think your friend taking your pencil would be on this chart? And you let them tell you. Now, they may actually put it up here, but that's okay. Let them do that, because you're going to talk about a few other different situations with them, and if they tend to put a lot of things up here, then you get to point out to them that it seems like this is where you put everything. So what would it look like to move it closer to this response, where I'm upset, but I didn't let it ruin my day? And you talk about how we can move these things down on the chart. Now, maybe they'll say, okay, yeah, when he took my pencil, I was upset and I did cry for a while, but I would put it about right here. And that allows him to see, or him or her to see, that there's room below that, but there's also room above it for more intense response. And it just gives them categories to be able to place things that happen to them in an emotional range. Does it need to be up here? Or could it actually be further down? And it just kind of creates a visual for them. And this has been really helpful for children who struggle in that area. So give it a try if you have a child who does kind of deal with that, or if you work with children, and let me know what you think.